Morning, YouTube. Well, I've been doing a lot of reading recently on the propagation of hardwood species because I want to plant an orchard out in my front yard, and some of what I want to have growing there is really just too expensive to be worth spending the money on. So I've been researching, and then this past weekend we were looking at moving a hedge to put up a fence for a friend of mine, and in this cedar hedge there was a sugar maple or a couple of sugar maple saplings and an elm sapling. And elm trees around here become quite rare since I was a kid because of Dutch elm disease, and an ash sapling or two that, well, ash is becoming quite rare now too because of the emerald ash borer. So instead of just ripping these down and grubbing them out to put the fence in, I decided I'd take a couple of cuttings to experiment with rooting hardwoods. So I've been looking at online again, and the North Carolina Cooperative, North Carolina State University Cooperative Extension, in their explanation of how to do this, suggests that you make a miniature greenhouse by cutting the bottom out of a milk jug and putting it over the flower pot. Well, my cuttings are a little bit larger than would fit inside a milk jug. And we don't buy milk in jugs, we buy it in bags. So today we're going to do a trash to treasure, making a miniature greenhouse system from one of those hanging basket pots that people bring you when they know you're a gardener, thinking, oh, Troll can save this. He does wonders with plants, even though it's an end-of-season annual that is just worn out and dying. And one of the disposable water cooler jugs. And a piece of geotextile that was leftover scrap from something my father-in-law was doing at his place sometime over the past 35 years. So, to get started, I want to cut more or less straight line around the bottom. And yes, I am just eyeballing it. Close, they almost lined up. Anyway, so now we have a base for the plant to catch any water that drips out. Or rather, a base for the planter. Cut a piece of geotextile in there because we don't want the sand all leaking out. Now, of the 200 or so websites I've looked at in the past 6 months or so, I have read about probably 50 different types of mediums that are suggested to grow rooted hardwood cuttings. One of the things that the University of North Carolina suggests is just straight sand. And since I have a bag of Mason's sand that came out of my father-in-law's garage as we were cleaning up, I'm thinking we'll use it. This is a trash to treasure video, and this is something that was, if we didn't bring it home, going to go in the trash. There is our miniature greenhouse for starting hardwood cuttings. That's it for now, and thanks for watching.